part 7 of Metroid Prime Remastered, and since the last episode, I went back on what I said and did a little bit of research online. I tried to do as minimal as possible, just to figure out what power-up I'm getting next. If I was missing something after how last episode went, and it looks like the boost ball upgrades the next one I get, and that is in the ice area, and it seems like I have all the upgrades I need. Again, I'm not exactly sure where it is. I'm sure it'll still be a bit of a struggle for me to find it, but at least I now kind of know what direction to go in. I'm not going to keep backtracking and going around in circles and probably driving whoever's actually played this game and beat it before crazy. Probably that last episode is very frustrating if you knew what I actually had to do to progress. Okay. Back to the ice area again. Let's play those freaking drones. Or cannon things. Those auto cannon turret things again. And still can't jump out of there. I hope that background noise isn't too loud. Someone's revving up an engine. Sorry, I do. Like I mentioned earlier video, I think in my Stardew Valley series, I do live in New York City, so not the ideal quiet environment needed for ASMR, but thankfully I do live in a relatively quiet, well, actually a very quiet area for New York City, so usually I record at night. So it's not as much of an issue, but I wanted to get a few videos done this morning. Oh, goddamn. Back down to the magma caverns I go. Ball is really gonna unlock. And crap. Like, I feel like I haven't been limited by the lack of the boost ball ability much. Oh, can you move, sir? Thank you. I feel like I've definitely been limited much more by the lack of double jump. And the lack of a grappling hook. Frustrating and embarrassing. But this video, we will get the boost ball at the very least. And I accidentally did see that once I have that, I can get the double jump. So, don't want to get too far ahead of myself, but maybe we'll get both. Onto that one. use of the dodge. Not a good use of the dodge. I was like, oh, I'll be smart and use the dodge for once, since I like barely ever use that. And that's what I get. Stopping my progress is that I hadn't checked out the shrine or artifact or whatever that told me about all those things I need to find, and then I got the notification about that new data reading. Maybe that was holding something back. Guess we shall see. Is there a minimum amount for to be considered umpteenth? Does it have to be over 12? Kind of a dumb question. Not anything important, but I've never thought of when people say umpteenth. Does that mean it's between 13 and 20? Or can anything be umpteenth? So from the spoilers that I did read, said something about some cavern. I still don't know. Can I? Is there like a way to lower these? I just... This is a safe spot. I should probably save back here so I don't have to redo all that stuff if I die. I have to be missing something, which is very on brand for me. I was gonna say maybe I should rebrand this channel as Clueless Gamer, but I remember that's Conan O'Brien already has that that branding. Fucking idiot. That's all I had to do was rocket that thing. God damn it. Well, who knows him? Not on this. Wow. Okay, note to self. And make sure to rocket everything. Don't just shoot it with a charge beam. Wow. Sorry for like anyone that, I don't know if it'd be OCD or anyone that's just not an idiot like me. If you've been like watching and just like screaming at your screen, you're like, you just have to rocket that. What are you doing? Why are you running all the way back? Like, I know when I watch stuff like that, it can be really frustrating, so I apologize for putting you through that. Scatter bamboo, pulsing tendrils of energy extend from the creature's body like all... Why do I keep saying bamboo on the first one? Bombus. Like all bombus, these creatures can only be harmed by electrical energy. Proximity to these life forms may result in electrical visor interference. It is possible to avoid engaging scatter bombus by rolling into the morph ball and slipping between the rotating energy streams. Good hint. I would have, well, did not nail that. Okay, can I get this one? Nope. Wow, I suck. first time I'd really played video games in like almost a year, so I'm a little bit rusty, and I was never great, like super good at video games anyway. Baby She Goth, Glacial Predator, Ice Shells Protect Vulnerable Dorsal, something. Young She Goths grow a resilient shell of ice on their back, which serves to protect a layer of vulnerable flesh. With this being their only weak point, baby she-goths will turn quickly in order to not allow predators the opportunity to strike at their backs. Powerful hunters, they fire bursts of ultra-cold gas at potential prey, then feast on their frozen victims. I remember something like this, I can't remember what. But is Metroid Prime Zero or something, or I don't know, a Metroid Prime game that I had. On Game Boy Advance had these type of enemies in them. Oh shit. Oh god. Scary. These would have definitely terrified me as a kid. Nothing to see here, just turn your backs. Just get bored. There has to be a better way to kill these things. Guess I'll just hide here. Man, I lost those power-ups. Those are babies. What the frick do the adults look like? I'm gonna run out of missiles. That's what I get for being like, oh, I don't need another missile upgrade. I already have more missiles than I need. Sleep, baby, shake off. Let me murder you in your sleep. Okay. I should be able to handle one of them relatively easily, but if there's two, that's kind of. Something I'm missing. this platform in front of my face. What a surprise. Wow. I feel like I have a lot of negative self-talk in these videos. I assure you I don't. I actually hate myself. But it is annoying how much stuff I blatantly miss in this game. These are just annoying. I hope I don't have to go through this area too many times. Well, you get to live. Tell your friends what happened. Okay, let's not jump back down there. Nice, more of these bombuses. Are these the same ones? Oh, shit. Oh, that's actually kind of good to know. I can, like, draw them all into one area. Oh, my God. Can I just, like, ignore these things and they won't fuck with me? Makes these missile launchers faster. Oh god, it's not dead yet. Oh shit. question mark, but it's outside the camera. Okay. Let's see. There looks like something there. But I don't think I can make it over that. I think I need to go this way. Classic. How? How did you have that reaction time? Are there any more of you down there that I didn't see? Oh, I'm gonna go read before I murder you. Guess I can't break those crates. So many creatures suffer beneath the blight upon the land, and we chose are no exception. But for all of our pain, we can at least believe in the promise of the future. We have come to believe that a time may never come when we can once again open the door and banish the darkness we have contained. Even so, our vigilance will forever remain. We believe that on some far-off day, a savior will come and continue what we have begun. For that savior, we will leave our ancient weapons and armor. The soul who can gather them will be the entrusted one, the only being who can reverse the evil that grows here. Why would they not make the weapons and stuff usable by their own people? Okay, let's see. Fuck. God, these things are nasty looking. Showing me that that's like a ramp. Oh shit. Okay, I can jump again. Nice. Stuck here forever. What the hell? Oh, I got ya. This thing's like a half pipe. Okay. Nailed it. Secret over here for me. Oh, I couldn't have made it up there anyway. this just in case I missed it the first time. It gives me an option to get back. What the fuck? Okay, well, I'm gonna get you out of the way. Maybe. What? Again. I don't understand the respawn mechanics of some of these enemies. Oh shit, I completely forgot about Ridley. Is that the darkness that's descended? Exactly where the double jump is. I just know that it is in the Talon overworld or ruins or something. Definitely know there's some stuff in the ruins that I can do now that I couldn't do before. And back past these frigging turrets again. I don't even think I have enough frigging missiles to kill them. Thank you. saying is gonna do it. Well, now I don't have much of a choice. Just jump up there, so actually fuck you. Wow, I feel like I'm getting much more crass. Just want the double jump. Is that too much to ask? Also, I just realized how few buttons this game actually has. It's crazy that almost every action in this game has multiple buttons you can use for it. Yet there's like a lot of abilities and different things in this game. That's very rare. I wonder how they pulled that off. It's like not even noticeable. Like, so jump is B or left button. Shoot is right bumper. Or A button. Something that I haven't been able to access via lack of a speedball. I don't exactly know where that is. All my beetle friends. Don't have time for you. Oh my, okay, phew. I thought that was 7 health. We're right about at 40 minutes. Should I call it here? I'll make this one another long one because I really want to get this double jump. Where? I really don't want to have to Google again. I know it's somewhere in the Dallin overworld. I don't know if it's here or if it's in the ruins. Oh, maybe. Can I not jump across this? No, I can. So that's not it. I know there's some stuff in the ruins. There's that one half pipe. That's something about an alcove. I know it's something about an alcove. I read that. But oh, okay. Here we go. Here's a half pipe for me. Never really a skateboarder. Oh, what am I even half piping here for? I don't even see the opening. Is it that bridge? I was so close for a second. Crap, it's definitely up there. This is promising. Let's not get my hopes up too high yet. Golly. This leads back to where my ship is. Am I missing anything? Okay, it's all starting to come together. Make it across here. a great way to end this video. Now I want to keep playing, now that I finally have those. Okay, well, the next video, I'm gonna go back to the Chozo Ruins West and just clear up all the stuff I missed. And then we will move on through the other things. I gotta jump around a little bit. This is sick. Finally. Can I do a jump? No, just single jump at the ball. Can you do like a bomb double jump? You can. Nice, I don't know if that's required anywhere, but we will end it there. A good triumphant end to this video. We got the boost ball and the double jump, which I've been waiting forever for. Now we just need the grab lock, flamethrower, and a bunch of other stuff, but yeah. Thanks for powering through with me. I know the last episode was rough. Hopefully this one redeemed it a little bit. And yeah, as always, if you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe. It really means a lot to me. Please leave any comment or feedback you have in the comments, so I can make these videos better for you. And I just appreciate you spending your time with me, and I look forward to seeing you again soon in the next episode, and hope you have a nice night. Bye.